Interference to television reception is why the Australian Communications and Media Authority has made lighting compliance a priority. It's important for manufacturers and importers of lighting, especially LED lighting, to ensure that their products comply with mandatory technical standards. LED globes contain complex circuitry, including switches, filters, and microchips, to manage the high-tech light-emitting diodes which provide light. LEDs are great for the environment. Unlike traditional carbon filament globes, LEDs can last for years, meaning less energy is used manufacturing and distributing globes, and less landfill is generated. And of course, LEDs use less electricity. So what's the problem? And where can things go wrong for suppliers?
It's very important that any importers of LED equipment, any suppliers of LED equipment, ensure that the product that they are supplying and installing conforms with our EMI, EMC regulations. There are standards which have to be met, regulations which have to be met, so they need to ensure that this equipment meets those standards. They can engage the services of a consultant to do that if they're inexperienced. My advice to any suppliers of this equipment is to ensure that their product conforms.
The regulations are designed to prevent interference to television reception by ensuring that LED globes meet mandated standards.
We regulate the supply of LED lights to ensure that interference isn't caused to radio communications and broadcasting services like television. The regulations are designed to be easy for industry to comply with while ensuring that high quality LED lights are sold in Australia. Suppliers need to provide LED lights that are fit for purpose and don't cause problems for the people who buy them.
Using a spectrum analyzer, ACMA field operation staff can identify LED globes that can cause TV interference in the household. After testing and measuring emissions from some LED globes, it is sometimes found that the emissions are much higher than the test report. If an ACMA inspector receives a complaint about an LED globe causing interference, this can lead to an audit of the supplier's documents and testing of sample globes in Australia by an NATA accredited laboratory. In general, someone importing globes needs to complete a declaration of conformity and have a test report showing that their globes meet the relevant technical standard. That is, that they do not create too many electromagnetic emissions or noise. Supplying non-compliant product can result in testing costs, fines, and commercial losses. Some practical steps importers can take include: make sure you have good communication and clear contractual arrangements with your overseas manufacturer. Make sure they understand that all the products they manufacture for you must conform to mandatory technical standards. Make sure that you can return the product if it does not conform. Conduct simple informal tests of your own on any new shipment of product. For more information, visit our website,